So all throughout high school, I've been in leadership positions because Ms. Putnam liked to challenge me, which I'm okay with. I love her to death. But this piece, I love it. It ties in English with music, so it's produced from a poem, Annabel Lee by Edgar Allan Poe, and he's one of my favorite poets. He's mysterious. And I've always liked this poem in particular, and I'm going to let Deanna Putnam and Ben Putnam explain more.
I'm going to read the program notes to you about the piece and how it was written, and then Ben is going to read the poem to you. Edgar Allan Poe, born 1809, died 1849, America's earliest master of horror in short story and poetry, led a life that paralleled his Gothic themes. Even in his exquisitely beautiful poem, Annabel Lee, written during his final year, the subject is believed by most to be his own wife, Virginia Clemm, who succumbed to tuberculosis in 1847. This work for concert band follows the three based sections of the poem, life, death, and remembrance, which the main thematic material, recurring as a sort of dialogue and counterpoint between the two lovers in the first and last sections. With the aid of muffled snare drum, expansive harmonies, and a persistent bass part, the middle section paints the picture of the desolation of a cold, windswept shoreline. Introduced at the beginning by the flute section, the Annabel Lee theme is stated again, five measures from the end, giving final witness to the bonds of love that even death could not separate.
Annabel Lee by Edgar Allan Poe. It was many and many a year ago, in a kingdom by the sea, that a maiden there lived whom you may know by the name of Annabel Lee. And this maiden, she lived with no other thought than to love and be loved by me. I was a child, and she was a child, in this kingdom by the sea. But we loved with a love that was more than love, I and my Annabel Lee, with a love that the winged seraphs of heaven coveted her and me. And this was the reason that, long ago, in this kingdom by the sea, a wind blew out a cold, chilling, my beautiful Annabel Lee, so that her high-born kinsmen came and bore her away from me, to shut her up in a sepulchre in this kingdom by the sea. The angels, not half so happy in heaven, went envying her and me. Yes, that was the reason, as all men know in this kingdom by the sea, that the wind came out of the cloud by night, chilling and killing my Annabel Lee. But our love, it was stronger by far than the love of those who were older than we, of many far wiser than we, and neither the angels in heaven above nor the demons down under the sea can ever dissever my soul from the soul of the beautiful Annabel Lee. For the moon never beams without bringing me dreams of the beautiful Annabel Lee, and the stars never rise, but I feel the bright eyes of the beautiful Annabel Lee. And so, all the night time, I lie down by the side of my darling, my life and my bride, and her sepulcher there by the sea, and her tomb by the sounding sea.